Hi, and thank you for joining me. On today's episode of Healthytarian Living, we are going to be making what I consider to be one of the healthiest type of so-called granola bars. Over the last few decades, we've seen a tremendous increase, not just in granola bars, but also all types of energy bars and different fruit and nut and seed bars. And while, of course, there are drastic differences in the quality that we can get today, with some not being healthy at all to others being relatively healthy, nothing of course beats making a homemade version where you got to choose and control the quality and type of ingredients, how you went about making it, so that you can really feel good about what you are eating. And most of the time, it is also a much more economically friendly idea where you will save money in the process as well. So you really have to make sure that if you are going to be picking a granola bar, an energy bar, any kind of a fruit, nut, or seed bar, that you really do examine the ingredient label. You also want to be mindful of the quality of the food ingredients. Are they organic or not? Where were they sourced? How is the whole bar processed, etc.? Because many of the bars that are sold today that have a lot of people still thinking that they're healthy are far from healthy. They're basically just a sugary processed snack, and that's really about it. So today's bar that we are going to be making is going to be made, of course, based on whole, natural, real foods. It's going to be loaded with various superfoods, and that's why we're going to call it the Superseed Energy Granola Bar. And it is going to be super easy, super delicious, of course, and super nutritious to make. Aside from the whole food ingredients that it will be based on, we're going to hope that our choices will be mostly, if not all, organic, as well as mostly raw. Now, the actual bar will not qualify as a truly raw product, but it's going to be mainly raw. There will be no baking, no heavy cooking, or anything like that involved. It will be gluten-free and wheat-free. Our bar is going to be super high in fiber. It's going to be naturally free of cholesterol and naturally low in sodium. It is going to use healthy fats, healthy proteins, as well as healthy carbohydrates. Our first and main ingredient will be the oat. And in this case, you're going to need quick cooking oats. Normally, I would only recommend steel cut oats, as they allow us to ingest the oat in its most natural whole food form. We can still enjoy the health benefits of oats, even if they're in their quick cooking form. However, they won't qualify as a truly raw food ingredient. So we are sacrificing a little bit of nutrition there. We always keep hearing how they help cholesterol and, you know, heart disease and things like that. Yes, that's all true and great. But in general, they're just a healthy carbohydrate where you're going to be getting those rich sources of fiber. You're going to be getting those rich sources of starch that are going to be translating into your body into excellent energy units. The oats are rich in various vitamins and especially minerals, as most grains are. Our next ingredient is going to be coconut oil. You want your coconut oil to be organic and virgin. If you can get a raw variety, a truly certified raw variety, that would be the best case scenario. So there's many coconut oil companies out there today, and I provide a guide to choosing the best brand on evolvingwellness.com. You can just type in coconut guide and you'll learn about the different coconut oils I've tried and what I recommend and why. The coconut oil I'll be using today is the gold label from Tropical Traditions, which is their highest form of quality of nutritional integrity. Coconut oil is an excellent source of healthy fats. It is rich in medium chain triglycerides, which are an optimal fuel for our brain and for our body and are not prone to being stored as problematic fat. It is excellent in terms of having antiviral, antifungal, antibacterial properties. It is tested for, you know, benefits with respect to Alzheimer's and keeping our brain healthy and such. There are some minerals, there are some vitamins involved, but also an amazing array of different antioxidants and phytonutrients. That's what makes the coconut oil so powerful as a truly healthy oil to integrate in our daily diet. So I write actually more about the amazing benefits of coconut oil on evolvingwellness.com as well. We are also going to be using some organic coconut, shredded or desiccated or flaked coconut. And your choice needs to be, or should be, for optimal health, organic and raw. And of course, unsweetened, not preserved. One wonderful company is Let's Do Organic. Another one is Organic Traditions. Both of these provide a coconut that is truly of a superior quality. It also has, aside from healthy fats, some protein, some healthy carbohydrates, some fiber, and of course, some vitamins, minerals, and antioxidants. Our next ingredient is going to be brown rice syrup. Now, my favorite comes from Lundberg, and they do have an organic brown rice syrup variety. Now, brown rice syrup isn't a truly raw ingredient because it does have to be heated to be extracted in the way that it is. So if you are looking for a truly raw sweetener, you can look for perhaps some raw organic agave. That could be another option if you are okay with eating agave syrup. You can also consider some raw organic honey if you're okay with eating honey. I personally prefer brown rice syrup because it's a thicker type of syrup that tends to make this granola bar stick better together. As well, it's not overly sweet, and brown rice syrup in general digests better for us in the body because it comes from complex carbohydrates rather than simple carbohydrates. So it digests more like a complex carb rather than a simple sugar. We're going to be using some kind of a nut butter. Now, my favorite one for this would be organic and raw almond butter, but you can also use hazelnut butter. You can also use peanut butter. You can really use any nut butter that you enjoy. In fact, change up this recipe just by changing the nut butter that you use, and you'll get a different array of flavors and tastes each time. So when it comes to nuts, of course, they are outstanding sources of healthy fats, healthy proteins, lots of different minerals like calcium and iron and magnesium and manganese, etc. Some vitamins as well, especially almonds. Almond butter has vitamin E, so that's also beneficial for our health. So just make sure that whatever nut butter that you find or use is the purest, most natural one that you can possibly find. Always aim for raw and organic. Next, we're going to be using some raisins, and that's really going to be our only other sweetener aside from the brown rice syrup. And raisins are a whole food. Therefore, the sugars that come from the raisins are bound to the fibers, to all the right vitamins, minerals, and other nutrients. So we can feel good about eating this. We know that raisins are actually extremely healthy, just like many dried fruits, for their energy composition for us, for their fiber composition, for their minerals, for their vitamins. So all around a nice food, of course, as long as we don't overindulge on it. When it comes to picking your raisins, again, very, very important because they come from grapes, that they are organic, as grapes are one of the high pesticide foods. So trying to source out some high quality organic raisins. If you can find some that are sun-dried, even better, to really make sure that they haven't been put through any drastic heat to degrade their nutritional quality. Next, we are going to be using a bunch of different seeds. Now, you can change this and make this recipe, again, unique to yourself, what your taste buds and preferences are, based on the seeds that you use. So think of pumpkin seeds, sesame seeds, hemp seeds, flax seeds, chia seeds. You can really get super creative and change it up each time so you have a different Superseed energy granola bar, depending on what you have available or what you're in the mood for. Today, we're going to be using the following three seeds. One, we're going to be using sunflowers. Now, sunflower seeds are an outstanding source of vitamin E, very healthy for our skin, cardiovascular system, and it's an antioxidant, which also gives protection against cancers, as well as the different minerals like some magnesium, like some iron, like some selenium, etc. Again, you're looking for organic and raw to have the best quality. Next, we're going to be using hemp seeds, outstanding nutrition if you're already familiar with them, for their omega-3 to omega-6 ratio. In fact, they are outstanding at providing us with the healthy fats from the omega-3, omega-6, and omega-9 families. They are loaded with protein, super easy to digest, rich source of magnesium and manganese, as well as iron, and also very rich in the B vitamins. They are also excellent at keeping us full because of the type of amino acids, along with the fats and fiber that they contain. When it comes to choosing your hemp seeds, or hemp hearts as they're sometimes called, there are really just a handful of really great companies that, if you're in the US, something like Nutiva has excellent organic hemp seeds. And if you're in Canada, something like Manitoba Harvest is a great choice. We're also going to be using some sesame seeds. Now, sesame seeds are also loaded in the B vitamins as well as the minerals. They are pretty much are best known for their calcium component. So as you can see from this type of Superseed energy granola bar, we're going to be getting an excellent amount of all those vital minerals we need, like iron, calcium, magnesium, as well as many of the trace minerals like copper, zinc, etc. And finally, we're going to be using some spices, with the main one really being cinnamon. And cinnamon, as you may have already heard, is loaded with different antioxidants, very, very high value, and of course some vitamins, some minerals, and some other phytonutrients. So excellent tasting and also excellent for us. Optional items that you can also include are spices like cardamom or nutmeg. What else is optional is pure vanilla extract or vanilla bean. You can also add a little bit of that for a delicious hint of flavor. And once you get really good at experimenting with what suits your needs and your preferences best, you can even add some carob powder or raw cacao powder to make it more of a chocolatey type of bar. So the possibilities are endless. You just have to start with whole, real, natural food, combine it in a creative way, and enjoy the outcome. So the process to make these bars is super easy. All you really need is some kind of a medium type of pot, medium or large size, at least a 2-quart, maybe a 3-quart pot. And what we're basically doing is combining all the ingredients in this pot over low to medium heat. You just really want to melt the coconut oil with the brown rice syrup, with the nut butter, then you simply just stir in the remainder of the ingredients. You're going to need some kind of a dish to put your bars into. I recommend a glass 9x13 dish. You can also use a 9x13 roughly non-stick pan. The preference always for health reasons is to go with glass. Other than that, some spoons for stirring, a measuring cup to measure your ingredients with, as well as a spatula or some kind of a tamper to pat down the granola bar ingredients into firm granola bars. So begin by turning on your stove to a low to medium setting. And we're starting with the coconut oil. We'd like that to melt first. You're going to need about 4 heaping tablespoons of coconut oil. And then you just want to begin to stir until the coconut oil melts. Once your coconut oil is fully melted, then you're going to add your nut butter. In terms of the quantity, we're going to go for 1/2 cup or about 4 heaping tablespoons. And once you've got the nut butter in your coconut oil, you can proceed right away to add the brown rice syrup. The quantity of brown rice syrup that you're going to need is about 1/2 cup, or likewise, again, about 4 heaping tablespoons. Once you've added the 3, what I will call your wet ingredients, you just want to stir them together a couple more times to make sure that they're all uniformly blended while keeping your heat on very low. So at this point, your mixture is a runny liquid. We are ready to stir in our oats, our seeds, and our spices. And just before you start adding your dry ingredients, you can turn off the heat as we don't need it any further. So start by adding about 1.5 cups of the quick oats and stir them thoroughly with your wet ingredients. The short amount of time that they will sit with the warmed ingredients on the stove is just enough time to really make them palatable. Quick oats are already very heated through, so they're very easy to work with, eat, and digest without needing excessive heat added to them any further. We just typically want to soften them up and reintroduce the moisture right back into them. So at this stage, your recipe is going to look kind of like a wet bowl of oatmeal. Next, we're going to add 1/2 cup of raisins. Follow that with your seeds. And with the seeds, you can pick about 2 to 3 of the seeds to use and use about 1/3 cup of each one. So here's almost 1/2 cup of sunflower seeds, about 1/3 cup of sesame seeds, about 1/3 to 1/2 cup of hemp seeds, and about 1/3 to 1/2 cup of the shredded unsweetened coconut. Finally, if you're going to be adding some of your spices or pure vanilla, you want to do so at this time as well. With respect to your cinnamon, for example, you can start with 1/2 teaspoon or 1 teaspoon or even slightly more. It all depends on how much you enjoy the cinnamon flavor. And at this point, all you have to do is just stir the ingredients really, really well together. So as I'm stirring, as you can see that all of the ingredients are mixing really well together. And you shouldn't really see any liquid left. You might even think, wow, this is too dry. How is it going to stick together? But we're really going to be depending on that coconut oil to do just enough of the firming action for us. So once you feel that everything is thoroughly stirred through and all your ingredients are basically mixed around pretty evenly, you transfer all of these contents into your glass dish. And that's it. Once you've got everything in here, you start to pat it down. Now you can use a spoon to pat it down, or you can use a spatula, or you can use some kind of a tamper. Whatever you choose, just make sure that you pat down very tightly all of the ingredients. And that's it, we are done. The whole process takes just a few minutes. Get your ingredients, start to melt the liquid ingredients, add in the dry ingredients, stir together, and press firmly into your dish. At this point, they are not ready to eat unless you really like a very crumbly type of mixture. So yes, you can use this in any way you'd like, but ideally what you'd like to do at this point to turn them into bars is cover it and place into the fridge. Let them cool, chill, and set for about a couple hours, perhaps. You can see, depending on the settings on your refrigerator, how long it will take. You should find that the bars cut and hold their shape very well. That's when you know that they have chilled enough. And that's basically it. So store them the whole time in the refrigerator. You can also freeze these for future use. They freeze really, really well. They keep really well for a few good days also, because as you saw, the ingredients are not easily perishable. Like I said, you can use this as part of your breakfast or a snack or a meal on the go, or even a type of treat or dessert. As you saw, based on the ingredients, this will provide you a super dense amount of energy in the form of healthy carbohydrates, healthy fats, and healthy proteins. So you're covered from the macronutrients, and with all of the superfood, whole food, natural food ingredients we've used in their organic and mostly raw forms, you are also covered for the vitamins, the minerals, the antioxidants, and phytonutrients. So an all-around all-star when it comes to nutrition, benefits for our health, and also delicious. I hope you enjoy making this meal idea, and I'll see you on another episode.